Hey you guys, it's Linnea. Today I have a quick and easy stamped background for you featuring the Ink On 3 Magical Dragon stamp set. So I'm going to be stamping with my favorite ink for Copic coloring, and this is the Blackout Hybrid Detail ink. And I love this ink because it is crisp, it is dark black, and you can use any kind of medium with this ink, whether you prefer watercolors or colored pencils with Gamsol, or like I'm currently trending towards, it are alcohol markers. So I've taken the three gems from the Magical Dragon stamp set and I've mounted them on an acrylic block, and I'm just going to ink them up and stamp all over the background of a piece of Nina White cardstock. You can use your Misty for sure to do this. I just find that it's easier to use an acrylic block. That way I don't have to keep cleaning my stamps in between. I can just kind of rotate that acrylic block around and get an even distribution of these gems. So I do want to note that the hybrid ink kind of sticks onto your stamps. So all I use is the Ink Off stamp cleaner and an Ink Off cloth. I just dab that on just like an ink pad, and then I can wipe that right away. And look at how clean and new looking my stamps are. You don't need to let this ink sit and dry. I only did the one stamping up and down, but if you're using your Misty and you're doing two or three layers, you might want to heat set it real quick or let it dry for a couple minutes. But for the most part, this ink is fabulous. It doesn't smear, which is awesome. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to color all of these gems with a whole rainbow of ink. And I will leave the caps in the top right corner so that you can see the colors that I'm using. I'm using some of my favorite Copic combinations for all the colors of the rainbow, from pink, red, orange, yellow, mint, green, blue, and purple. All I do when I have a stamp background like this, because I do want to make sure that I have an equal representation of each color so that my background looks balanced. So I counted all of the gems, and then I think I have 8 colors of the rainbow that I'm using. So I went ahead and just divided by 8, and I got that it was like 5.3 gems per color. So every 3 or 4 colors or so, I did 6 gems, but for the most part, I did just 5 gems per color. And I just add a dark outline, or use my darker marker, so I'm using 2 color blending. And I'll just go around the edges and where I think there should be some shading for the marker, or for the gem rather, and I'll use my darker marker and just add some shading and then blend out with my lighter color. And I'm just, as I'm coloring, evenly spacing out these gems so that I don't have 2 colors, or 2 gems of the same color rather, right next to each other. And then once I'm done, I'm going to take my BG10 marker and outline each of these gems. This takes a couple extra minutes, but I really think the end result is worth it because it helps those gems pop off the page. I went ahead and colored some dragons from the Magical Dragon stamp set, and I used the same color combinations as I used in my background. I have a simple stitched die cut shape here for my little dragons to rest on, and I'm going to pop them up with some foam tape. I'm going to grab a sentiment from that Magical Dragon stamp set, and again, I'm using my Blackout Hybrid Detail ink to get a nice crisp black stamped sentiment. This card is almost finished, but every gem and dragon should sparkle, right? So I have some liquid pixie dust, just plain. I didn't dilute this with water or anything. I squeezed some into a small fine tip watercolor brush from Ink On 3, and all I do is just give it a good shake. And then I can easily paint on some liquid shimmer across all of my images. I hope that you enjoyed this look at some of my favorite Copic marker combinations and coloring a background featuring the Magical Dragon stamp set. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I'll see you again really soon. Bye!